Hey y'all, I'm coming at y'all with another banger today. And in today's video, I'm gonna be giving y'all boys my three best builds in NBA 2K20. And the first one off the bat I'm gonna show you is the two-way slashing playmaker. And the pie chart you wanna choose is the yellow and red, and you wanna choose the vertical pie chart. And you want to put all your attributes to how I do it in this video. You want to make sure you put it to exactly the exact attributes if you want to be a GOAT like me. Simple. If you want to be GOATed, if you want to win every game at 2K, hardly ever lose, make the builds that I do in this video. These are the top three builds. And you'll realize that there's only one shooting build in this. Because to win in this game, you could either ice. There's two ways of playing in this game. It's ISO or screens. I run ISO because I'm a two-way slash and play. And play glasses ISO. All those ISO builds, they're goated. It's so hard to guard ISO. It's very hard to guard ISO. I'm a really good defender, I would like to say, and it's super hard to guard ISO. You want to copy all my attributes right there. You want to make your build compact, and you want to put your height to 6'5", and you want to put your weight all the way down to 177, and the wingspan you're gonna go like, I think it's two away from the lowest. And you want to make sure you do lockdown defender takeover. That's the one thing that I messed up on my last build. On this build that I have, I put slasher takens to the lockdown takeover. Please do me a favor and put lockdown takeover. It is like the best takeover in the game, especially for when you play comp. You can get it way more quicker. It's way better. It's just so much better in general, y'all. Just please don't make the mistake and put slasher or playmaking. Please do lockdown takeover. You could do slashing if you're just trying to have fun, but lockdown pretty much does the same thing. Next build we're going to make is the rebound and wing. So what you want to do is make your guy small forward. You want to put all your stuff to the way I put it in this video. You want to put your drive and layup to 70 so you could get those long athlete layups, because if y'all did not see the recent video, and go check that one out after this one, I showed y'all the best dunks and the long athlete layup package, best animations in the game by far. You guys just want to copy down what I did here for the rebound and wing. You hardly get any playmaking, you only get one finishing badge, but you're not trying to like do anything crazy on the dunking side. You're a straight spot up pretty much. You're pretty much a spot up. This is a spot up build. It's like the best small forward build in the game, I would like to say. Pretty much is the best build for small forwards. It's the best spotter build, I would say, in the game. It's whatever your playstyle is. You guys can make any of these three builds. It's just whatever your playstyle is and what you like doing the most. I personally don't like waiting for someone to get me open. I like getting open myself. And the height you want to do with this build is 6'7", y'all. You want to make your build 6'7", so you can become, you're fast, you can do everything good. Great shooting. You only need a 77, and when you get like 98, you'll have an 83. And you want to put your wingspan to where I put it in the video. You just want to put it to 85.7, and make sure you choose spot up shooter takeover or lockdown defender takeover. It's really what you want to do. I personally chose lockdown take because y'all know how much I like lockdown takeover. If you watch any of my vids, you know how much I love it. In the next build I'm gonna be showing y'all is the playmaking glass cleaner. This build is so toxic. I hate playing this build. I honestly sometimes run from it. Psych, I don't run from none unless you're two legends, but shit, still might run it. So this build is pretty much a two-way slash and playmaker, just taller. 6'7" two-way slash and playmaker, I like to call it. And you just want to make your build a power forward. You want to do the yellow and red pie chart, and you want to do exactly what I did with the attributes in this video. You just want to make sure that you get your playmaking to where I put it and your shooting where I put it. You're only going to get one finishing badge, which is really not that big of a deal, because you're going to be doing crazy shit. You're going to be like a straight demon, and you're pretty much like a complete lockdown defender on this build. You want to like max out everything on defense. You get like 20 defensive, I'm pretty sure you get 20 defensive, and you want to move around. You want to get more rebound, and interior defense is kind of eh. You don't really need it. It's like decent if you take a couple off. It's not going to do shit. You're still going to get bodied unless you don't have moving truck. really doesn't do shit. Post defense is ass in this game. And you guys want to make your player burly. You want to make him big. Because you want to look way bigger than everyone else. You want to go 6'7". You want to go like the lowest weight possible, I'm pretty sure. And you're not going to have T-Rex arms on this build, y'all. You're going to put it to where I put it in the wingspan. You're going to want to go with like 81.9 and choose playmaking takeover. Or you could choose rim takeover, but I like playmaker because you're like a power forward. Playmaking take? It's pretty OP, y'all.